Now let us consider AC voltage applied to LCR circuit, series LCR circuit. So all the three, inductor, capacitor and reactor, reactants are connected in series. Now let us assume an inductor of self inductance L is connected to a capacitor and then a resistor. So all the three are in series. This arrangement is connected to an AC source. This is called series LCR circuit. All the three are connected in series. Now let I is the current passing through them, because in series combination total current passing through it is same. Now we know that pure resistor is taken, a pure resistor connected to AC source. We know that E and I are in phase. That means phase difference phi is 0 degree. Suppose if I take pure inductor, in a pure inductor circuit E leads I and phase difference is 90 degree. Similarly, if I take a pure capacitor, E lags current and the corresponding phase difference is 90 degree. So if I take pure resistor, pure inductor, pure capacitor, pure resistor E and I are in phase, but in pure inductor E leads I and the pure capacitor E lags I. Here I am taking a pure LCR circuit. For this let us take a phasor diagram. Here I is constant. So first in the phasor diagram, this is my x axis, this is my y axis. In all the three, since I is constant, so take I on the x axis. Now if I take the resistance, we know that in the resistor I and E are in same phase, where E means E resistance, ER. But pure inductor E leads, so leading I can show this inductor EL along the positive x y direction. At the same time, now capacitor E lags, so let us show it along the negative y direction. So this picture, phasor diagram, clearly says in a resistor E and I are in phase, in a inductor, pure inductor, EMF leads current, in a pure capacitor EMF lags current. Since I is constant and series I am taking, keep x axis I and remaining positions like this. Now here EL and EC are in opposite direction, therefore if I simplify this one, I can say this is my ER and the resultant of these two, maybe EL is dominating or EC is dominating. If I take EL is dominating, that will be like this, EL minus EC. The angle between them is 90 degree, so net I can consider it as root of ER square plus EL minus EC whole square. This is the net EMF or applied EMF. So applied EMF we can consider in this way, E is equal to ER square plus EL minus EC whole square. But we know that E is equal to I into R. So if I substitute that one, this is I into R, so I square R square plus here I into XL, because here the impedance, inductive reactance XL minus I into XC. So here I square, here also I square comes out. If I take common, this is I times root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So if I take this I to the left side, So EMF by current is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. This is what we call impedance, denoted by this symbol Z, impedance. So what this impedance represents? It is the total resistance offered, total resistance offered by the circuit for AC. When AC voltage is applied, the total resistance offered by the circuit is what we call impedance. It is nothing but the total resistance. So if I change this phasor diagram in terms of these resistances, because it is E is nothing but I into R on all the sides, L is I is present, so I can show R along positive X direction. This is my XL and this is my XC. Suppose if I assume in any circuit, LCR circuit, XL is greater than XC. So I can show this diagram as this is R and this is XL minus XC. The resultant of these two, if I consider, that will be like this. Let us say this is the resultant and which makes an angle phi. This is the phase difference between this current and this is my I and R. So here I can write tan phi is given by opposite by adjacent, that is XL minus XC divided by R. Because if I complete this one, so this is my XL minus XC, and XL minus XC by R, it is what we call tan of the phase difference. So I am considering the phase difference, but it is a tan of the phase difference is equal to tan phi is nothing but XL minus XC divided by R. Now here, so the Z term, Z is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Suppose if I want to see more current must pass through, more current must pass means Z must be small. If the impedance offered by the circuit is small, since I is equal to E by Z, if Z is small, then more current passes through the circuit. So under what conditions resistance Z becomes small? The only way, suppose if this term XL minus XC is equal to 0, then automatically implies Z is R, which is the small value or the minimum value. So XL minus XC is equal to 0, or I can also write as XL is equal to XC. So when the inductive reactance and the capacitive reactance both are equal, then the resistance offered by the LCR circuit for AC is very very small and the maximum current will pass through the circuit. So the frequency for which this is possible, XL and XC are equal, because as frequency increases, we know XL value increases but XC value decreases, since XL is equal to L omega or L into 2 pi F, whereas XC is equal to 1 by C omega, that is 1 by C into 2 pi F. As F increases, XC L increases but XC decreases. At one instance, these two can be equal. So if I substitute here, L omega is equal to 1 by C omega, or omega square is equal to 1 by LC, or omega is equal to root over 1 by LC, or omega is nothing but 2 pi F. So frequency of AC, F is given by 1 by 2 pi times root over 1 by LC. This frequency is called resonance frequency. The resonance frequency of AC is given by 1 by 2 pi times root over 1 by LC. For this frequency, I is maximum. The frequency of AC for which maximum current passes through the circuit is given by 1 by 2 pi times root over 1 by LC. Normally, in general, if XL is greater than XC, it is inductor dominating LCR or inductance dominating LCR. But suppose if I say XC is greater than XL, that is also possible. Then it is called capacitance dominated LCR. If XL is equal to XC, resonant circuit. AC circuit is said to be a resonant circuit when these two are equal. So normally the applied voltage we can calculate. So what voltage is applied in an LCR circuit? The applied voltage E is given by root of ER square plus EL minus EC whole square. This is what we call applied voltage. You are applying E voltage, but across this one ER across the resistance and EL across the inductor and EC across the capacitor. So normally the phase difference between EMF and current, if you take, so already we got three values. Suppose let us say this is my R and this is X, I will call it as, which is nothing but XL minus XC, and this is what we call Z, and this is taken as phi. So this is the phasor diagram in general representation, where tan phi is given by X by R tan phi. Suppose if I take sin phi is nothing but X by Z, or cos phi is equal to R by Z, where Z is the impedance. That is, the impedance is nothing but the effective or total resistance offered by the circuit. That is what we call impedance. If one remembers this LCR concept, it is easy to find the relations for the other things. Suppose if I say CR circuit. So in the previous equations, that is Z is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square, put XL is equal to 0, then you will get the CR circuit equations. Z becomes equal to root of R square plus X square. Similarly, I is equal to E by Z. So applied voltage E is given by root of ER square plus EC square. Similarly, if I take only RL circuit, it need not consider LCR, maybe CR circuit or RL circuit. Again, same thing, Z, forget capacitor term, so XL square. So applied voltage E is equal to ER square plus EL square. So I is equal to E by Z. So like this, depending on the given data, we can calculate the remaining quantities. So in any circuit, power is given by the power value is given by P is equal to E into I, or average power P average is equal to VRMS or ERMS into IRMS cos phi. So by using these equations, it is possible to calculate what is the power in this circuit.